All righty, happy Thursday.
Happy Thursday.
I am Rashida Lucas.
And I am Dalila Lucas, and we are your favorite Lucas twins.
So, how you feeling today?
I feel great in yourself.
Your eyelids are beat.
Yours too. Close them.
Shout out to Tatiana Kemp on that makeup.
Ooh. Yes.
But we have some great topics today, and we have an amazing guest. She is very special to us. So before we even get started about any topics, about any hot news that's going on right now, we want to introduce to some and... Oh, she's looking at me like, no, I don't get nothing to say. But I want to introduce to some and present to others none other than Miss Martinique Peaches Logan. In the
Hey, Peaches! Hey, Peaches!
Tell her to call you Martinique today. Your name's Martinique. She's going to call you that anyway.
I'm sorry, Martinique. Hey, Martinique. Hi, girl.
We are so glad that you were able to fit us into your busy schedule because you're a very busy woman.
Yes.
Yes, yes. No, there's no T words. There's no T words.
No T word. You are.
A hard worker.
There you go.
I got 16 jobs.
Oh, okay, mom. You Jamaican?
Yeah, no.
Oh, just Jamaican?
I'm just after the money.
You just a hustler.
Yeah.
H-U-S-T-L-E-R.
That, pretty much.
I get it, because that's what I do.
Oh, yeah, I mean, you have to. You got to get it out here. You know, when you're not a woman who's waiting for...
A man to take care of you
and pay your bills. You have to do it. Now, mind you, I'm not with the independent movement. You'll never hear me say I don't need a man because I do. Every woman needs a man and every man needs a woman.
Hello.
But I was also raised to handle what I need to handle until he comes along.
That's right. What it is right now.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Because no man, if he's not your husband, he is not obligated to take care of you.
That's true.
Not at all. But if you want to.
I know that's right.
Only if you want
now,
to.
Now, I'm not going to ask.
I don't knock anybody's blessings.
Not at all. I'm not going to block your blessings.
No. I'm going to let not you give all. What you need to give so you can receive what you need to receive. I won't stop you from
you
that.
You reap what you sow. Is that the
and
right
it's
thing?
Reaping
no, that's karma.
Oh, it is.
This is my.
It's harvest season.
Yes.
Okay.
This is
like
my season.
So before we get into the topics, we want to ask you about yourself. So tell us a little bit about what you do and what do you have going on and how's life?
No complaints.
I know that's right. It ain't going to change nothing.
It's really not. But everything is good. Constantly working, but I just completed entrepreneurship program.
All right, now come
Sunshine
on, big ball.
Enterprises.
Hey, nice.
So I am now currently an entrepreneur.
Yes. Yes.
My own business, and I am a mother of a business owner as well. So my daughter has her own eyelash, lip gloss, and t-shirt line.
Come on, now.
Yes, and I see her doing.
Yeah.
Her thing.
And my son is in the process of being the next business owner. Yeah, go Dina.
Come on.
My crazy baby girl. So very proud of her. But that's what I'm working on right now, trying to get the business launched up and running before the end of the year.
Hold on.
You say what?
We have to
it's that word again.
I am getting the business up and running.
Thank you.
So we can be off the ground before the end of the year.
Okay.
And just handling the legal end portion of that, trying making sure all my T's are crossed and I's are dotted.
It's not easy, is it?
So.
But as you get used to it, it'll be normal.
It's a process, but it's good. It's a process.
Oh, no, I'm talking about using that T word.
Yeah. Cause
so what made you want to become an entrepreneur?
That wasn't a want. It was a need. The necessity to be financially independent, the necessity to set an example for my kids.
That part.
And I see a lot of people doing it. I mean, no one that I know has the particular business that I have or is doing what I'm doing particularly. But, I mean, I know tons. We know collectively, tons of entrepreneurs, business owners, independent business people. So it was just time.
Yes, and retired nice. Life is amazing. Especially when people say, you're too young to be retired. And I have to tell people, and this is something that we
learn.
You don't know
yeah.
what you don't know. So we've always put retirement with age, but retirement doesn't have to do with age. Retirement has to do with your income.
Right.
So.
True that.
Yes. Saw an opportunity almost 6 years ago, and I was like,
let me get that.
But at first I almost shooed it away. But then it was, like you said, start thinking, kids, legacy, building empires. What am I going to leave for them besides debt or, you know, or just nothing. So,
yeah, I learned just through my family alone that a lot of times when different people died in our family, that's what was left behind. It was just debt or, you know, handling the closing of affairs or whomever passed away. And it was nothing that was like for them, maybe their kids or for their family to be like, this is what they left behind. So.
Right. And really nothing that can be carried on.
Right. The very least I want to have, you know, for my kids, they can say, well, we got a couple of different places to live. She got some property she left us.
Nice.
You know, at least.
Right. At the least. Most definitely. So what kind of business are you going into or do you have?
I have a delivery service. It's a particular delivery service. I'm not going to give all the details.
I used to do delivery services.
So
way back in the day. It was a business. I can't say it was a legal business.
Well, then we both used to be in that business.
Always been entrepreneurs.
It's a legalized business, delivery service.
It's a legalized business.
Yeah, for anybody getting any ideas. So, yeah, that's it. I saw that it was a couple of other companies out here doing it, but they were only doing it to a specific target area, which we're not really included in. So I was like, I'm going to bring this to the South and West Side.
She looked me up and down.
Which way, though? Because, I mean, you know, I go in the right neighborhood. Pablo and them was going down.
You know.
Hefe.
Right.
Which way? She can actually go in all of them.
You can except
for the Asian one.
Yeah, they.
Well,
no, nobody wants to
no.
No, nobody wants to be that.
No Chinatown for you.
No, I'm good. No meow for me. Thank you.
Well, I'm going to tell you that okay.
I like soy sauce on my cats. I don't know about nobody else.
I did a little dibbling dabbing with meow, soy sauce.
Oh, yeah. Salsa.
Might I add, the stigma is a lie. The stereotype is a lie. And it was one of the best experiences ever.
Oh.
Take a trip to Chinatown. You won't be disappointed.
Whoa.
She like them spring rolls.
Definitely the spring rolls. I think it was more like a super egg roll.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
Ancient Chinese secret, huh?
Oh. Definitely ancient Chinese secrets. But back to being entrepreneurs. I was in the business of foreign affairs.
Okay.
Yeah.
There you go.
I'm an entrepreneur in everything.
Is that what you call it? Foreign affairs.
I like that. Yeah.
So I was in the exchange business with my oldest two children.
That sounds real Mission Impossible like.
It was. It was Mission Possible. But when you say impossible, you separated it. I'm possible.
Right. Okay. There you go.
But so back to now what I love about the conversations that we've had and even what you spoke about just now of getting your children into businesses. How old are your children and what was it that made the light bulb switch and say, you know what, instead of just focusing solely on go to college or get a job? What made you say, you know what? No, instead of working for somebody, get you a business and have people work for you.
Well, a few components went into that. First of all, I have three children, 23, 20, and 17. My oldest is my son, Brandon. My daughter, Dina, is 20. And my baby, Amir, be 17 in January. That's my star football player who's
Is he a Capricorn?
Yes. He's an Aquarius. He's an Aquarius.
Just about to say how amazing.
He's an Aquarius. Yes, he's an Aquarius. So the first thing that came into play about it was my sister was a previous business owner. She had her own business from, I think I was maybe a sophomore in high school.
Nice.
And at least 5 years. I can't really remember exactly how long it was. So I used to work in a shop with her. That was the first person that I was closest to that had their own business, was an independent business owner. just setting an example, I was telling them by me working so much and working so many jobs, I refused to be a slave to one income or to a business because I've learned over the years. I've been working since I turned 15. I turned 42 a couple of weeks ago.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Virgo Nation. Birthday. Thank you.
You know, my best relationships have been with Virgo.
Hey. So.
Friendships too.
Good.
Any relationships around the board.
Good. But I wanted to set an example and be kind of like the poster child for my kids and show them, don't be like me and work all these jobs, hours, work all these days. You can be independent. You can have your own business. It's a reachable goal. It's not too hard. You know, it's not something that's not attainable. And the first person to jump off the porch and run with it was my daughter. She's crazy, but she's extremely intelligent. And we had a few conversations, and she came back, and she was like, Ma, look, this is what I want to sell, this is what I want to do. And she just kept going with it. She created her own website. She found wholesalers. She got a logo. She tweaked it, made it her own. Mm-hmm. And she just took off with it. And I was like, hey, that's what I'm talking about. So originally, when I first moved back here, when I first came back home, I found a different program that was very similar to the one I just completed at Sunshine Enterprises. And I started out with that, and I was on my way. And the employee I was working for at the time, she decided to hire me on as full-time as an administrator and an HR administrator. So I quit the program. So the guy who was teaching the program at the time is pretty much a genius, extremely smart dude, like chemist, super smart.
Yeah,
so
he's smart.
I found out that he was teaching at Sunshine Enterprises a few years back, and I was like, okay, he's there, so I can pick up the program here and take this class again. And I just put it off, and this year I was like, it's no more excuses. And I had somebody who I was previously cool with, they really kind of pushed me behind the scenes, and he was like, once you get that tunnel vision, you take off. So what you waiting for?
All the words.
So I was like, okay, well, I guess I don't have no excuse no more. Mm-hmm. So I did it, and it was really good. It was better than I anticipated it to be, and I had some ladies who were in my class. It was a few of them. They were like 50 and older. So I was like, if they can do it and they not quitting and they like, we going to reinvent ourselves, I don't have no excuse.
Yeah, I know that's
never
right.
Never too old. It's never too late to start. The thing is that you started.
Exactly.
There are people, you know, a lot of mentors say that a lot of people are dead, they just aren't in the grave yet.
Absolutely. Not only are they dead mentally, they dead spiritually.
Right. And they say, what are you going to do with your dash? And what that means is, you know, when you pass away, they have the year you were born, the dash, in the year you died.
Right.
What is your dash going to say about you?
Right.
What did you do with your dash?
Yeah. Well, everybody is different. For me, just being tapped into spirituality, I want to live a purpose-filled life. That's what I'm here for. Because I didn't ask to come here, but that's what I'm here for. So pretty much I'm just trying to make sure that I live my purpose and stay grounded, stay prayed up, stay close to God so he can give me the blueprint of what that purpose is.
Pull
my loved ones along with me. Hopefully I have a husband and I'll help him with his.
You will.
Yeah.
You will.
He'll be
He's
going to
be amazing.
He's already amazing.
Come on, say that.
He's already amazing.
Yes, he is.
And his name ain't Grace.
I'm hoping not.
So, yeah, that's the plan.
I'm really going to hope his name is not Grace. But let's go ahead and get into our first topic. Why don't you go ahead and introduce us? This is Dalila's topic.
Uh-oh.
All right, first topic. Are you ready?
Yeah, drum roll.
Calling the other woman.
Okay.
Would you or have you done it before?
We're going to ask you first, and then I'll answer.
Would I now? Absolutely, positively not.
You already know that now.
No, no, no.
Right.
Have I done it? Probably, maybe close to 20 years ago. I got on the phone and told her all the business, gave her a piece of my mind.
Uh-oh.
Wow. So, yeah. But now for what?
Exactly. What?
Anybody, I think that's a young person's thing. Anybody that's 35 or 40 that's still wanting to call another woman, unless it's something, you know, really way out or, you know, something extremely serious. For what?
Like an STD.
Or a baby on the way.
Or better yet, your husband is sleeping with, you know, my wife and they're jeopardizing our job, you know, something like that. Because fraternizing with, you know, corporate jobs can get people fired. So, you know, a lot of times people are not thinking about the repercussions and consequences to the things that they're doing, but absolutely not. For what? That conversation should be a conversation with you're supposed to be man. If that was really your man, you wouldn't have to be talking to another woman. So the line of communication got dropped somewhere, somebody on a different page.
Somebody ain't even in the book.
Right.
Now, I'm going to answer and say, I'm like you, now, no, I haven't done that in years. Dinky 20s, definitely did it. Did I start 6'7"? Definitely did not. did I sit there in silence? Definitely did not. I had some things to say.
Absolutely.
Actually, this just happened to me about 2 days ago.
What?
Yes. Had a private caller. And so my daughter was in the car and she was laughing because when the person called, you know, they just sit there and not say anything. And I was like, hello, hello, you're going to call me and not say anything?
Right.
That makes no sense. Mm-hmm. And then I said, I don't think it's fair that you have my number, but you won't let me have yours. If you have any questions to ask, go ahead and ask them.
And they said,
if there's anything that
the
you know,
time.
I'll definitely tell you. And then they hung up and then they didn't call back. I'm like, okay, whoever this is probably like, this lady is something else. I'm not calling her back.
Mm-hmm. But you like me, you answer the private calls.
Well,
I answer.
I answer all calls. I answer private calls.
Unknown numbers.
I answer calls to numbers I don't know. You know, ever since our mother was sick, before she passed away, you know, when you have some real life, like for real emergencies going on in your life, you understand the importance of answering all calls.
Well, I did that when I had kids.
Yeah.
That just happened to me this past weekend when my son was in his football game. He dislocated his shoulder. And I was at work. I had my phone on the charge. And I came back and I had all these missed calls from unknown numbers. And I'm like, let me call these people back. But my dad and my sister called me. So I already knew. I was like, wait a minute.
Okay.
Something happened with Amir. What's going on? What happened? So, yeah, because it was like, I think both of his coaches and maybe like physical therapists or something, they all called me.
Yeah. Wow.
Now, would you call somebody? Or
no.
Have you?
Yes, I have called somebody. When I was around 22 years old, yes, I did. I was 22, and that was the one and only time that I called somebody.
Now, you know what? The times that I did call, now let me give this disclaimer. The times that I did call somebody and the women that I called were women who were in my face.
Now,
hugs and saying, hey girl, coming to my shows to support me, but messing with my man at the same time. Oh, I'm going to call you, ma'am.
Yes, now this person I did know. Because she would rub on my belly. How the baby's doing? Yes, I did call her.
Devil.
Now, calling somebody, I'm not calling you. And at this age, I'm 41. I'm definitely not calling anybody.
If I feel like I have to call somebody, then I don't need to be with you.
Exactly. I don't need to be with you. And number one, I'm not going to call a woman to make her stop calling my man. What kind of crap is that?
That it's not going to stop, though. The only person that can stop it is him. And I
exactly. He don't want it to stop.
That comfortable.
Exactly. He definitely doesn't want it to stop. That's why he's still contacting and staying in touch.
Or not only that, if he is a married man, he's out here living his life like a single man.
Definitely.
And trust me, the woman who you're calling, I'm pretty sure she doesn't know he has a girlfriend, has a wife, or has somebody who thinks they're his girlfriend.
Now, it's very messy.
Super messy.
Now, I have a question for both of you ladies. What is the end result of calling the other woman?
For me, it was just to let, at the time when I did it, even though I was much younger, it was just to let her know, if that's what you want that bad, you can have it. But he's still at my door. He's still on my phone.
He won't leave me alone.
I'm still getting a couple of little bills paid. So I don't. What's the problem?
That was when you was getting paid your bills paid.
Okay.
$10 a month. At Flame James.
Right.
Not Flame James. You took it way back. You would told everybody.
I'm talking about the
website. Yes. Have no idea what we're talking
about.
Heck
no. Right. That's a Wild Hunters only.
Right.
Yep, and Rosalind. Now, what's the end result for you, Rashida?
For me, usually there is no end result.
I agree.
You just call somebody, but like you know, it's like Martinique said. Most of the time, he's not leaving alone the woman that you call. And here's my thing: stop calling if you're going to stay. It's dumb.
That's the whole thing right there.
You look like
that's the main issue.
That's the biggest issue.
Why are you calling if you're still gonna be there?
That's the main. The thing I can say is that's happened to me. I think I might have made a phone call once or twice, but that's happened to me more times than I can count. And the crazy part about it was 75% of the time, it had to do with a guy that I was not messing with.
Mm.
I didn't know like that. When nothing sexual going on.
But they just saw your number on the phone.
And one girl told me, she was like, I'm calling all the numbers in the phone. There's females. She was like, you the fourth one. I'm like, oh, you got a lot of time on your hands, baby. Why are you there?
If you have to call everybody. Exactly.
You already at four.
But y'all know what it is. We live in a day and age where women will deal with, and we all know them, we know some collectively together, they will deal with whatever and whoever just to say they got a man. That's where their self-esteem is at.
I can't do it. I'm good.
God gave me a hand, he gave me 10 fingers. I'm cool on the batteries.
I don't need the batteries. Let me tell you, I don't use a hand or batteries. My thing is out of sight, out of mind. I just go to sleep.
Not only that, like just get a business, do something to keep yourself
stay occupied. Yeah, exactly.
I ain't got that much time. No. I don't have enough time, you know, for dealing with the individual I'm dealing with, and vice versa. So I'm like, baby girl, you got a lot of time on your hands.
Too much.
Now,
entirely too much.
Does calling the other woman make you insecure?
It depends on the situation. Because let's say this is a married woman who's calling the other woman. As a wife, you have all rights in the world to call.
Yeah, you do.
Whoever it is. And that doesn't necessarily make you insecure. It's just saying, hey, lady, he's a married man. We have a...
Because there's some married men around here walking around talking about they single and people really don't know they married. I mean, women
don't. Oh, yes.
Oh, I got duped by that.
Oh, definitely. That happened to me before, too.
Yeah, I've been duped.
And as soon as I got that phone call, it was a wrap. I never talked to him since then. Like, dude, you got a whole wife. You out here being nasty.
Yes. So,
well, some of the men will tell you, oh, we don't live together. I live over here, she live over there, which might be true, but if y'all ain't together, like,
why is there still a marriage? Show me
a divorce.
Show me your divorce decree and then holler at me.
Right.
all that we sleep in separate rooms. That may be true.
It could be true.
It could be true. But I'm not gonna sit at home and be and try to debate if he's telling the truth or not. No, you're married. When you get divorced, holler at your girl.
And I might not be available by the time that happens.
That part.
That's a long process.
That part. That part.
Oh, well.
That's a long process. Like, you could be fine and all that, but it is not fine enough for me to wait 2 years.
Now,
not that enough, that much fineness in the world.
Now, here's a good question. When you are calling the other woman, when you pick up that phone and dial those, and you dial that number, and it rings, are you really ready to hear what she has to say?
Ooh, you hitting us hard tonight, aren't you?
Hey, it's Domestic Violence Awareness Month.
I'm about to, okay. You know
but I'll be on it. Oh!
I had to deal with this for 41 years.
Here's the reason we wore our wife beaters today.
That was my idea.
It was. Yeah. Good job.
I know. Thanks.
Good job.
I was like, hey, it's Domestic Violence Month.
Maybe let's wear our wife beaters.
Okay.
You see the purple eyes. Like,
and we got purple eyes.
Okay. I see you.
Right, boo.
So, again.
So, as you answer first.
When you call, are you ready to hear what she has to say?
Being on both sides of the spectrum, absolutely. Being on the side where I was the woman that was being called, and instead of hearing what she had to say, I was giving her a lot of information that she might have not knew about or that she might didn't want to hear. Because, yep. I mean, y'all know my personality. Y'all know me. I'm
straightforward.
Don't bite your tongue. Exactly.
No chaser. So,
no chaser.
Nah.
You know, if you wanted to have a conversation with me, we're going to get real, real fast.
Oh yeah.
And it's going to happen in a politely rude way.
Yeah, I'm not sugarcoating anything. I'm not pacifying you. You call me, I'm going to give you what you want.
I'm not going to call you out of your name. I'm not going to be, because like eight times out of ten, the woman is in as much in the dark as you are.
Well, they know.
Well,
a lot of them know.
Don't.
Some of them know because they just not reading the signs. They might not know it's another woman, but they know the red flags.
Oh, yeah.
They know it's something wrong. They know something not end up. They know something's going wrong. But, I mean, at this point, at this stage in the game, we don't deal with that anymore. I mean,
right.
I'm a kinder, gentler.
Right.
But 20
I got
years
called
ago,
in July at the age of 41.
Wait a minute. 20 years ago? You'd have got invited to my house. I'd have gave you my address and been waiting on my porch for you. We can have a face-to-face conversation.
So look, I got called in July at the age of 41, and I wasn't even the other woman. How about that?
It happens.
The woman that he messed around on me with called me.
Wow.
It made it like, you got kicked to the curb. I'm the new woman now.
Oh, she had a lot of kahunas.
Oh, she was very cocky.
Super cocky.
Very cocky. A lot of balls.
I got something to cock. Where she at?
So much so. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on.
Oh, I'm sorry. I took it way back. Let me come back.
Put that back in your purse. They ain't ready for all that. Yeah, okay.
I said at 41, I'm not going to go through this.
She couldn't be
that. You don't have to. I will for
you. She couldn't be that cocky because she was insecure enough to say what she said. So she wasn't cocky. She just wanted to try to come across as being cocky.
Well, yeah, and that's a great point because it's also to the point where, well, let me see this so I can. Well, all she's trying to do is convince herself of these things.
That's all.
But so my answer to that question is, you said, are you ready to hear what they have to say?
Which is the truth.
Right, and that's exactly why when you said it, I said, yeah, when you make that call, you have knots in your stomach because you don't know what you're going to
get. Yeah, all kind of gas.
Right, you hear babies in the background. You're like, whose baby is that? His? You know what I mean? Like, wow, when did that happen? I'm about to send you the pictures from my baby shower. Wait, this man had a whole baby shower?
And I'm the type of
together.
Right, and I'm the type of person in any type of situation. And you call me, do not ask me questions that you don't want to hear the answer to.
And I actually say that. I say,
don't ask me questions you don't want to hear the answer to.
Because, like I said, this is why we've been so close for years. Because we're the same. Like, there's no chasing, no ice, nothing. Just straight up.
Ain't no lemonade, huh?
Nothing. It's gonna put hairs on your chest.
Yeah.
Like on your esophagus lining a little bit.
Now the next topic is a segue into this one.
Oh, okay. Give it to us.
Go ahead. Don't give it.
So the next topic is, which is actually why it's really actually a good segue into this, is when is it too long to stop fighting for someone? Meaning someone who isn't putting in the same 100% that you're putting in. Now, granted, nobody's 100% is the same. Nobody's 100% has the same ceiling level.
Mm-hmm.
But they aren't giving, they're not showing you that, hey, I want this. And they're just doing so many disrespectful things, like blatantly showing you, I don't care about your emotions. I don't care about your feelings. I'm going to do what I have to do, and I'm doing it because I know there's no consequences.
Okay. Well, that ain't happening over here. Okay. First off, we're going to be real respectful around here. I try.
She said around here.
I put forth the effort 110% every day to be respectful above all things. So that's not gonna happen. But I think it depends on the situation, because you can't just shut down and say I'm done fighting. I'm not gonna fight for this person. And y'all have an investment. Y'all live together. Y'all pay bills together. You know, y'all raising kids together. Whatever the situation may be. Sometimes it's cut and dry. Saying, you know what, I'm done with you. I'm done with this. You got to get up and walk away. So I think it depends on the relationship at this point. For me, if I was in a relationship, I feel like it shouldn't be a fight. We should be able to communicate, articulate, and have a conversation amongst ourselves to get on the same page and to get an understanding, so it won't be a misunderstanding. And that's it. You know, I think you should fight for your marriage. I think if you've been in a relationship with somebody, I think if you're in a relationship with somebody and y'all have a business relationship as well as an intimate relationship, I think that that's something to fight for, because you have something invested outside of your emotions. Because I think it's a smart move to be in business with somebody you're in a relationship with, because every day you're not going to be in love, and every day you're not going to feel like, you know, we lovey-dovey and we laid up. Sometimes it's, you know, we get into the grind and we get into the hustle, and, you know, iron sharpens iron. So where you weak, I'm strong, and where you weak, I'm strong, you know. So those type of relationships, I think you should put a level of fight into it. But if you're not getting some type of reciprocation back, where he's communicating to you, I'm trying, or this is not my true intention, or I'm having an issue with this, or I got that going on, then you gotta say, I'm gonna cut my losses. And one thing about women, it's a general statement for us women, we leave mentally first before we leave physically. So a lot of times, which is kind of weird, because we will take men back, but at the same time, it's like when you shut down in my mental, you shut down in my emotions.
I'm not French.
It's time to go.
Definitely.
Do you know, my kid's father, shout out Frank Lopez, is the one who taught me this phrase like 20 years ago. He's always say, only crabs walk backwards, and I'm not a crab. Okay. So I tell guys that all the time, I'm not a crab, because I fight so hard for something. So once it's done, that's it. I don't go back. Because if it had to end, then
you could take a break from a relationship. I think you could take a break, or, you know, take a time out to kind of sort things through. But really breaking off and getting back together,
No,
I
have broke up with someone I was in a relationship before, or we had a mutual agreement to break up, and we got back together later on. And the components of why the relationship didn't last was not the same reason as to why we broke up originally. So
now, if it's mutual, that's different.
Yeah.
I think that's different, like to work on yourself and stuff like that, and then get back. That's different.
Yeah, because you might want to actually be with that person, but it's just bad timing right now. That's why I said, I think, you know, a break or a time out in certain relationships with certain people might be good for the relationship down the road.
I agree.
The only time I would go back is if it was somebody like in younger years, because you're like, oh, we were kids. It was a little puppy love.
Right.
Okay, come on, let's try this again. We're grown now.
Right.
Yeah. Or if it was somebody where the breakup wasn't due to damage.
Okay.
The breakup was due to maybe we just grew apart, and maybe somebody was too busy and the other person couldn't do, like something like that, something like that. But like where there's just a whole lot of damage, hell to the no.
But let's be real. Let's get to the core of that. That's the reason why most relationships are not happening, because people do not know how to heal. We are in denial about the healing process. There's a couple of different ways you can heal. You can heal, you know, through mental, you know, mental therapy. Nobody wants to go see a counselor. Nobody wants to go to therapy. Nobody wants to see the psychologist. We as people of color, we don't.
People don't like doing that.
Right. We don't need that. And then, you know, on the spiritual side, you might have a woman, you know, that's like, you know, come worship with me. Come pray with me. Read the word or the Quran with me. Let's get, you know, let's get together. Let's get on the same page. And the man might be the opposite and might be like, I'm not trying to do that. I'm not on none of that. So people are still dealing with past hurt from past relationships, even from their childhood. I was with a man for 2 years that had mother issues and was in denial about it.
Let me tell you something.
Broken men are the worst.
I've been in two relationships with men with mother issues, and I've dated several. For some reason, I was trying to figure out why I kept attracting people who needed to be fixed, but I found
you're a
out
healer.
Because I have a
you're
fixing
a healer.
Spirit.
You're yeah. a healer.
So, but I was like, those men are the worst to deal with.
Because they don't want to be healed.
They don't want to forgive. They won't let go of that pain.
Nope.
And they don't realize that that stuff trickles over into every relationship that they have.
Absolutely. Not even that. It trickles over into their bloodline.
Yeah.
It now becomes a generational curse. And I'm a generational curse breaker. So if you hold on to
come
that,
on, breaker.
We can't. We not gonna mesh. It's like oil and water. It's just not gonna happen.
And men like that, they can't even love their kids right.
And men, you know, men call out women who have daddy issues, but they don't call it that. They say they gold diggers or they no good or they ain't shit, you know, or something like anything like that. But it's really a woman that has father issues because she don't
by choice.
She don't stop it. Because she don't have a father, or she didn't have a father in her life. You know, so
I was promiscuous due to an overload of hormones.
Okay.
Oh God.
Hormones.
I think I have more testosterone than estrogen.
Uh oh. That's why you're walking away. That's why they're still chasing you.
Now, do both people have to fight?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Think about it. The boxing world would not make millions of dollars if there weren't two fighters in the ring.
Well, it's not considered a fight if it's not two people.
Well, and there you have it. You just have Trey swinging in the air on Boys in the Hood.
It's not a fight. That's called an ass whooping.
No, you by yourself.
It's just one person.
I'm sick and tired of all this. That's how you.
Girl, shut up.
Shout out to
Cuba Gooding Jr.
No, you know what? I just thought about something. I think that's a great example. To people who are in situations and you're the only one fighting, you look as silly as Trey did swinging at the air.
But women don't think that though. They don't think that. Women.
I'm most calling women that.
Not
that.
All women, but most
okay,
women
Trey.
Don't.
Let
most women don't
Trey.
Think that. Most women don't think that, and that goes back to what I'm saying. Get women it. Will deal with. That's why I'm gonna keep it honest. That's why we single. That's
Give
why we single because women
are gun tray.
Women are deal with whatever what just to say they got a man. It's
yes.
more important just to say yes. I have a man than to have a real man that's bringing something to the table. Like I can't be with a man that can't teach me anything. If you can't
Ooh,
teach me anything,
oh,
if
so
you can't
excited.
Motivate me to level up, I don't need you.
Call on
I'm
me.
A boss by myself.
Call
I'm
on me.
Making moves by myself.
Call on me.
Rush right here.
Light bulb just came on. What you said, and you said why we're all single. Guess what? So we live in a world that is, and this is not just guessing something, this is realistic. Majority of people are raised by single parents. We are all daddy's girls. You're still
every
a daddy's
single's
girl.
One of, you better believe it, baby.
You're still a daddy's girl.
You better believe it.
We were daddy's girls to the core. So when you're a daddy's girl, you get put up on
So much game
from both sides, and you talk so much. So it's not easy for people to pull the wool over our heads, and a lot of guys don't like that. No. They can't deal with it.
Yeah, and you know, my sister is 11 years older than me, so I learned a whole lot before most people our age knew it, because my mother used to make my sister take me everywhere. Mm-hmm. So I mean, I knew what a condom was at 6.
Damn. Wow.
So, you know, I'm 2 steps ahead of the game, but like you say, I'm still a daddy's girl. My daddy will be 82 in January, and I'm like, my daddy is the coolest man walking. And I will argue anybody down about him.
Freaking amazing.
I will argue anybody down about him. But
dope.
My daddy set a standard for what a man should look like, mm-hmm. taking care of the household, being a good person, supporting his daughter. Not only his daughter, my mother's daughter, which is pretty much his daughter, because he's been in our life. My sister knew him before I got here. So, you know, it's a standard there. It's just a standard for what a man should look like. So, I mean, I know what it is. I know who he is. I know where he at, too.
So now I'm gonna
get your act together. Act right, please.
Okay.
I'm being
class
patient.
Is in session. So next question. When does fighting become toxic?
Fighting becomes toxic when you allow these the disrespect and the negativity to take over the house.
Ooh, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in.
I'm a plastic collection place.
Let me elaborate. Okay, so we're women. We're very emotional. I think I'm, like Rashida said, I think I got a little more testosterone than estrogen.
I think all three of us. I think our whole crew had more testosterone.
Because we cut from a different cloth. We're not like most women.
I don't cry.
Our whole crew is cut.
I don't even cry by myself.
Shout out to
I'm emotionless.
Shout out to Coco, Danielle's, a couple of us, Rochelle, Sydney, of course. Yeah, we cut from a different cloth because all of us are very similar. But women are extremely emotional, so they'll take those emotions and run with them as if that's the reality of what's taking place, and it's not. So what happened in your mind and what you're feeling in your heart transfers over into what's taking place in the household and in the relationship. That's when it becomes toxic. That's when it's like, okay, it's time to go.
How many babies does he have to have on you?
It's time to go. How many babies? I thought we was done making babies, even though I'm having baby fever.
No. We're talking about the situations that, when we were talking about fighting and how long do you fight, but now we're talking about when it becomes toxic. And like, some of these toxic situations is when the guy, and I'm not bashing men, I'm not a man basher, let me put that out there, but in some situations
that
I know, the guy is still having outside children.
Oh no, that's
when
a,
do you let
that's
him
a
know?
That's a deal breaker for me. Now I'll come to the defense of men. I will say that men will have sex with other women or have had sex with other women, and there won't be any emotional ties for them because that's what men do, and they'll be like, I ain't care nothing about it. It was just that, and it was it. But when you start having babies, hold on, wait a minute now.
You're just reckless.
It's time for me to go.
Irresponsible.
It's time for me to go because that means you having unprotected sexual activity over there. You have an unprotected sexual activity over here.
Hello, somebody.
And let's flip it. I've also heard lots of situations where, because there are a lot of guys who will vent to me, and they have situations where they're like, she don't do anything anymore. I'll take care of everything in the house. She won't cook. She won't clean. I'm always with the kid.
Where are they at? Where are they at?
Oh, they're out here.
Oh yeah.
And they're staying dealing with goofballs.
It's not about the money, but don't get me wrong. If a man is doing everything in my house that I need him to do, he ain't got to worry about clothes being washed. He ain't got to worry about meals being cooked.
Thank you.
He ain't got to worry about clothes being ironed. I'm running all his errands. It's a bath waiting when he get there.
And he's going to get a rodeo show.
Oh, come on now. We are professional cowgirls. Didn't we go bull riding last summer for my birthday? We are professionals at this right now. Come on now.
Yeah. And he doesn't even have to ask for, what's the medical word for the body part up here on top of your shoulders?
What? Oh, he has to ask for the fellatio. Thank you. There's the technical word for fellatio. Thank you, sir.
All that.
See?
I'm pretty sure you are.
Most men are.
I'm yes. Most men are.
That's where a lot of men lose out at, though. They get sprung and they lose all their good sense.
I'm an advocate that I don't think your man, if he's your man, ladies, I'm not talking about just some random goofball out here, but if he's your man, I just don't feel that he should have to ask for that.
Not
especially if he's an amazing man. Like, when you have a king and, like, his crown is on straight,
you ain't never got to ask me because I'm initiated before you do.
I tell people all the time. Just saying, I was born with high cheekbones, these biceps in my face.
I cannot right tell now.
Come on now. Now, another question. I follow this pastor on Instagram named Pastor YPJ TJ. I think that's it. He did a two and a half minute video yesterday on toxic loyalty. So my question is, when does your loyalty in fighting for someone become toxic?
Go ahead, because I know what I'm going to say. You answer first. You're the guest.
Okay. Let me give a disclaimer. I am a Virgo and we are loyal to a fault. That is my gift and my curse, because I have been loyal to people who did not deserve it at all.
That's Capricorn.
Y'all pray for me. That's a gift.
Both earth signs.
That's a gift and a curse for me. So y'all pray for me, because I don't believe in being phony. I don't believe in phony kicking it. I've had a few relationships over just friendships and even a couple of relatives over the past couple of years. Those relationships have been severed because I refuse to be a yes person and just, you know, say everything that they want to hear. But loyalty becomes toxic when you're not getting that loyalty in return. I feel like I don't ask for a lot in a relationship. I just want you to treat me the same way that I treat you. So if I can't get 80% of that 5 or 6 days a week, we got a problem, Houston. Now, I'm going to give you 110%, but that's just me. I'm going to go get it. I give you my all the time. But give me 80% 5 days a week. Now, if you're giving me 20, 30, and 40, 3 days a week, we got a problem. It's something wrong. But it's not a lot of women that are being loyal. Listen to what I'm telling you. I don't have a lot of female friends, and a few of my friends will front and stunt like they loyal to these men, and they got these men lined up. I mean, they lined up, and she got them all in order. She got them in check. She got them doing what she need them to do, but she ain't loyal. She can be.
And I'm pretty sure she's not happy either.
No, she ain't.
I had to tell a male friend of mine the other day, and he's super loyal to his woman. He was like, in the middle of the night, you know, he'll wake up and she's sneaking, messaging people on her phone. I said, she ain't 100% into you.
Not at all.
I said, her options are open. Trust me when I tell you.
At the same time, she doesn't want anyone else to have you.
Because she know that you're a great man. Exactly.
Well, that's being selfish right there. But not even that.
That's selfish.
I know y'all seen the meme on Facebook where it says a lot of people aren't in relationships, they're in situationships, or they're just in relationships because they don't want to pay their bills by themselves. It's a lot of women that's sticking in these relationships because they don't want to pay these bills by themselves.
I call them convenience ships.
Those are convenience.
My bills by myself, but I refuse to be in a toxic relationship.
And I wish I had Section 8. So if anybody knows, if the list is open, put
me in the lottery.
The list is open. Rashida J. Lucas.
You're going to pay that $25 on time.
What?
That's like I got it.
It's only $25 for the people that don't work. People that's got a real job, they got to pay a little more.
I mean, I get residual income. I don't know if they want to count that, but I'll pay it. I have to tell a male friend of mine that's married.
When I tell you, he does the absolute. He goes over the top for his wife, and it'll be months that they don't have sex. And when they do have sex, it's like a chore for her. I told him, I'm gonna tell you this as a friend and a sister. She is not in love with you. She don't even want to be with you. She is only there because of what you do for her.
Because let me tell you something.
That's real.
Not having sex At this point, it's not about you. I'm punishing myself. I tell people all the time, I will have sex with you mad.
Thank you. And go to sleep.
I'm not depriving myself of anything.
Not even that. Wait a minute.
There's not a headache too strong. There ain't a bellyache that.
But that's why.
Tired in the goddamn world.
But that's why a lot of men don't want to commit and be married, and that's why a lot of us aren't married. But if I'm married, that's exactly what it does. If my husband, he gonna be like, "Can you please close your legs, my husband?"
No, let me tell you.
It's going down every day. I'm kicking kids out the house and everything. Grandkids, y'all can't come over to Tamar and let me in. Don't come over here at the nine. It's a porno show. It's Pornhub over here. Don't come over here.
Girl's dad, it was so bad that he used to have to tell me, "Baby, can we just cuddle tonight?"
Right. Stop playing.
Can we just lay here and talk?
My husband.
I'm sitting there with attitude.
My husband, he done gave me his last name. Now. Stop playing. It's like an infomercial on YouTube, and she's an Asian chick, and she says, "I'm the baddest B-I-T-C-H," and she's like, "I can do the splits three different ways. I'm 54 years old. I'm in the gym 6 days a week for 2 hours. She goes hard. That's how hard I'm trying to go for my husband right there.
Ain't no trying.
How hard?
Right? I am.
Going that hard for my husband.
Ain't no trying.
You don't get that T-word out of her vocabulary.
I am.
Before the year is over.
But you know what? Shout out to Rozelle Eccles on my Facebook timeline. I know he posts these questions every day. And he posted a question 2 days ago, why men today don't want to get married. And do you know it was 100-some comments, and like 80% of the men said that exact same thing that you said.
Man.
And why they don't want to commit.
How could you?
Yes. How could you stop? Who stopped?
Listen, ladies,
I can't wait to get dentures.
Ladies, if you married and you don't like your husband.
I don't do them.
Toys
can't choke.
I don't care nothing about no toys.
Toys don't talk back. They don't sweat in your eye. I can't do it. I don't do toys. I'm not into toys.
Neither am I. That ain't my thing. Mm-mm. Why get a toy to do something that I could get you to do?
A toy can't.
It's called motivation.
Right. A toy can't be like, "Whose is this?" It's not gonna say that.
I don't know. It's just
they
me.
Made something to do.
I don't know.
Toys can't choke me.
Right. If it can't do this to me, no.
I'm a church girl. I'm not supposed to be fornicating all my church members.
We gotta do it.
Okay.
We're on to the best part.
We have a game that we played before. I don't know if you've seen the show, but we have a game that we play with our guests, and it's called the ad-lib game. You know what ad-libs are?
Yes.
Okay.
She's smart. She's a Virgo. She knows everything.
Is. And she used to be, never mind.
Never mind.
I'm not going to do that today. It is Throwback Thursday.
They know what time it is. If you knew me 20 years ago, you know what time
you
it is.
You know what time it is. I'll just say, pardon the body.
There you go.
Yes, sir.
Anyway,
yes,
people
sir.
People are going to be like, "Oh my God, they crazy." Okay, so you ready? You ready for the ad-libs?
Okay.
All right. So we're going to give you the artist, and you have to give the ad-lib.
They're the most famous ad-lib.
Some of them have several, but you do it. And you have to do it exactly like the artist.
Yes.
Okay, so you ready?
Okay.
Casey and JoJo.
Ooh, yeah.
Hey! She's the first guest who ever got it
right.
Stop playing. Stop playing. I've been listening to Jodeci on Pandora every single week.
They be giving verses. We're like, no, that's not ad. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Let me turn it so you don't cheat.
Trey Songz.
Go, girl. It's your birthday.
No, that's a chorus.
No, his favorite one is.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Okay, Cardi B.
Oh Lord, I don't listen to her.
What?
That's not it. The little roll of the tongue, I can't do that.
I ain't got that skill.
I have some other ones though.
Bordy
or Cardi.
Oh, okay, I don't listen to her.
Okay, Migos.
I don't listen to
them. You just did this. You just did it. Michael Jackson. You gotta know this one.
Which one? Come on.
That's a good one.
Which one?
That's a good one. That is a good one.
Yes.
Come on, he a Virgo now. Wait a minute.
Okay, go ahead, Rashida.
I just did, Michael Jackson.
Oh, okay. Lil' Kim.
The baddest mama?
No, that's Trina.
She's kind of close.
No, she's
like, I'm the queen bee.
Yeah. Yeah.
She always queen bee. Yeah. Or if you say Biggie, she do that all the time too.
Yeah. You know, now you know what? On the Notorious Kim, she used to do just like Biggie. She used to, on all her songs. That's a throwback of Kim right there. She used to do that.
Junior Mafia. Yes. You ain't all right, R. Kelly. Hey, we's AIDS. I can separate. I still got AIDS.
Y'all don't want this answer.
I'm sorry. Here, camera.
Y'all don't want this answer.
We just talked about
he still peed on somebody, kid.
Hey, she let him, so AIDS. That girl was rolling better than me.
Yes, she was.
Okay, go
like
ahead.
Like she was grown.
Yeah, R. Kelly ad lib.
I wanna ride.
No, that's a chorus.
Give me one. I don't know.
It's Kels.
Oh Lord.
Happy people, baby. You say that all the time. Okay, last one. This is gonna be fun. Keith Sweat.
Uh-huh. Girl, I can't cry that hard.
I can't cry that hard.
Nobody. I can't cry that hard. You may be young, but you're ready.
Okay.
I'm going to play this.
Now, listen, now don't play. Don't act like we was not jamming off that at the brink on 87th Street. Stop playing. We weren't even trying to go home till they played Keep Sweat. Anybody under 25, they don't even slow dance. Y'all know that?
No, I've noticed they don't slow dance at parties anymore. That's what we got to do for our birthday. We got to have a party, a 90s party, and we slow
dance party.
Oh,
it's slow dance all night.
It's an R&B party. Slow
y'all better
song
give
songs
a disclosure. Somebody go. Now, you know what? Dalila.
And I'm going to have a bag of panty liners on the
listen,
day.
Dalila, you know what happened last time. You better give a disclosure. Somebody get pregnant.
It's
going to
be panty liners on the candy table because after all that grinding slow dance, somebody going to have to go change them. Candy liners and condoms.
Right. From all that dry humping.
From all the dry humping. And you got to wear your best used Jabot damage outfit.
Not Jabot.
Triple fat goose coat and A-ball jackets.
Yes, it's Throwback Thursday.
Damage. We got to go to the thrift store.
And your LA Gear boots and your Lottos and change the sign that match your clothes.
Man, quit playing. I'm coming in there with some Diodoras on.
British Knights.
British Knights. But that is our time. We want to thank you
so much for
being. We knew it was going to be fun when you got booked to be a guest.
Yes.
But you are more than welcome to come back.
Y'all
anytime
are my favorite. Well, I just came to see y'all a couple months ago. So, yeah. You
yes,
know, I got to come back.
You are very
you call me all the time.
You support everything.
You call me all the time. And I be feeling so better. Like, I got to work. I'm at work.
I just
I'm getting to go to work.
You know, I did come to your birthday party. I was parking lot kicking in for like an hour and a half.
2 hours. Y'all was in the parking lot for 2 hours.
Yeah, but we didn't know it started that late. And I was tired. And she got young people problems. Our babysitter was calling. So...
Yeah, and I was cute too.
Oh, we was inside acting a fool.
I know you was.
We was inside acting a fool.
Again,
I love y'all.
We love you too. But again, thank you for coming out and coming on to your favorite Lucas twins.
My favorite twins.
Yay! And come out, be a part of our live audience.
Yes.
Please, please, please. I'm begging. I'm being vulnerable, and I'm begging you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You guys got us up to 120 subscribers. The goal is now 200. It takes small goals to get to the big goals. So 200. Follow our page, Your Favorite Lucas Twins, and come out or watch us live every Thursday night, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. I am Rashida Lucas.
And I am Dalila Lucas.
And we are Your Favorite Lucas Twins. Good night.
Night-night.